Hi viewer, I welcome you to Link TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 4, Lesson Number 20. The topic is Fishing. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today. We are going to look at the comparison between the fishing in Japan and Kenya, then management and conservation of fish. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to give the similarities and the differences between the fishing in Japan and Kenya, and also highlight the management and conservation of the fish. We start by looking at the comparison similarities. Number one, fish farming is done in both the countries. Number two, cooperative societies for the fishermen is practiced in both countries. Number three, marine fishing is done in both countries. Number four, same species are caught, that is sardines and tuna. Going to get that they are caught in the two countries. Differences. In Kenya, both marine and inland fishing is done, while in Japan, only marine fishing is carried out. Number two, marine fishing is confined to Kenyan territorial waters only, while in Japan, marine fishing extends beyond the territorial waters up to the high seas. So you can be able to see the differences. Some more differences. The marine fishing in Kenya are few and limited fish and species, whereas in Japan, the fishing ground is richer with a variety of the species. So you happen to get that in Kenya, we have few and limited species. But when you go to Japan, remember it is found in Pacific Atlantic, Pacific fishing ground. In Kenya, marine fishing is done on a small scale based on simple technology and use of the traditional methods. Whereas, when you go to Japan, it's done on a large scale that is based on the advanced technology and use of modern methods. How do we manage and conserve the fish and the fisheries? Management. We manage these fish and fisheries by licensing of the fishermen to control their fishing activities and to regulate their numbers. So you start issuing of licensing, and these will now limit the number of fishermen and even to control the way they are using the water bodies. Number two, banning of the fishing when over-exploitation is detected on a particular ground so as to give the young fish time to mature and breed. This is now the second way. We ban the fishing in those areas where over-exploitation has taken place. So as a result, you happen to have to give the fish time to mature and rebreed again. Number three, it is the standardizing the size of nets used in the fishing to ensure only the mature fish will be caught. This is ensuring that the nets are standardized, which they cannot get the small fish, thus reducing over-exploitation. Number four, it is the intensity research to know about the fish species, their habitat, breeding habits, food requirements, migratory behavior, and lifespan. So if at all you make the studies on these, the habitats, where do they do well, their breeding habits, what food do they require, how do they move, where are they this season, where are they this one, their lifespan, then we can understand it better. Now, conservation. Encouraging fish farming to supplement the fish caught in natural fishing ground. So you encourage now the fish farming people to do the fish farming. And this one now reduces the rate at which they go to the natural fishing grounds. Number two, control of foreign fishermen by monitoring their expedition through the KWS patrols. So you control the foreign fishermen from coming to their water bodies. Then, restricting the disposal of untreated waste into their water bodies, ensuring that there is no water, untreated waste, it is not disposed in the water body. Improving transport system through construction of roads connecting the major fishing grounds and the market to reduce overexploitation. That is also another one, conservation. We improve the transport system. Number five, it is the restocking the overfished areas using the hatcheries and the figaries obtained from the Lake Basin Development Authority. Those areas where we have overfished, we can restock the fish from the hatcheries, from the figaries. Then, the law of the sea that restricts fishing in the exclusive zones ensures the protection of marine fisheries from external exploitation. So they restrict, they replace the rocks. For more information, you can refer from KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 4, that edition. You can get us through SMS, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, and also you can tweet at us. Stay tuned to Erim TV.